feel your boundless grace. We ask that you bless us with knowledge and understanding as we study our lessons for today. Help us, dear Lord, to be obedient to our teachers and to be caring and respectful to our classmates. Be with us, inspire us, and lead us to be more like you. May our doings for today bring honor and glory. In the name of Jesus, our Lord and Savior. Amen.
Hello everyone, here's the second to the last lesson that we will have for this subject. And last meeting, we talked about personal essay. And today, what we will have is the expository essay on how to critique and write your very own. Now, expository writings are the result of a writer's attempt to find out something. The expository writer seeks to explain, instruct, describe, or clarify something for the readers. The expository essay is also known as informal essay. The expository essay presents facts or pieces of evidence that support explanation and a clarification for a topic. This type of essay demonstrates your knowledge and understanding of a subject and is very useful in business communication, journalism, science, and government. So we've already discussed what is an expository essay way back on our previous lessons. And right now, we're just having this refresher first parts of our discussion about an expository essay, which aims to explain certain things, certain facts, evidences, and to clarify a certain topic. Now, our topic is all about how we can critique and write our very own expository essay. And on critiquing and writing one, we need to have expository techniques. So the expository essay relies on the four W's. What are those four W's of expository essay? Those are the what, when, where, why, and one actually H. So there are four W's and one H. That H is none other than how. Now, facts do not explain. They attest to your explanation. Explanation requires the technique to make it effective. So facts are there not to explain. Facts are there just to tell what happened and what is the truth. So on your own or on your own way of explaining, those facts will actually come alive. So all in all, an expository essay really relies on how you can express those facts or those clarifications about certain things in a creative way or in a creative manner. Now, how can we explain those facts on our expository essay? We can use the following. The first one is we can have an analogy or referring to equivalent or similar cases. For example, you will going to refer to the violence of both of these two images. That shows the first one, someone who is firing a gun, and the second one, someone who is in the battlefield. Okay, so there was this equivalent similar cases wherein there are both violence in the same images. So that is the first way that you can explain something through analogy. The second one or the second way for you to explain something is through analysis. So you need to analyze or separate the parts or elements of a subject. So just like in this images or in this virus or image of a virus, we could have this virus as the subject and its parts as the elements. So here we saw how the virus was analyzed through its parts, right? Next, number 3, the cause and effect, or finding out the cause and consequence of an event or action. So, on this one, for example, we can have this, think of it as, for example, the cause of a volcanic eruption and the effect of it to the people living near it, right? So, for example, let's remember or let's have a look on what happened when Mount Taal have this volcanic eruption and its effects to us, okay? As parents, as students, as teacher. So, that is another example of how you can explain things through cause and its effect. Next, number 4. You can do the classification or grouping of people, objects, or ideas according to shared similarities. So, for example, this animal classification that we have here. So, we can actually explain much more better if we have certain classification of things. Okay? Next, another example or another thing that we can explain things or another way for us to explain is through comparing. So, you can compare and contrast or find similarity and differences between people, objects, or ideas. For example, this one, the comparison between this orange and an apple. So, we can see here the differences of the difference of an apple to an orange and their very own similarities. Next, number 6. We can have the definition or the explaining the meaning of word, phrase, or idea. So yeah, there. So the definition is there. So show that explanation to your readers in a creative manner. Next, 7. You can have an explanation through illustration of a particular case to support your argument. So how can that be? Example of it is just this one. Just give an example of itself, okay? Number 8 is the process analysis or explaining the step-by-step procedure on how something is done. So, for example, in this one, how are humans evolved from the theory of this one is that we humans came from a certain species of monkeys and then we evolved through time to being as who we are right now. So we can see here a step-by-step procedure of how something become this in the final product, right? Now, and those are the 8 ways for us writers on how we can explain the things or the topics that we want to explain in an expository essay. Now, how are we supposed to read and critique a prompt or a writing prompt? So let's all first remember that all expository writings are a response to a prompt, which points out the subject of the essay. So the prompt will ask the writer to explain or make a claim about a subject. So, an excellent expository essay directly answers the prompt with valid and properly used evidence. Use the following indicators when reading and critiquing an expository essay. So, we already know how we can explain, okay? So, right now, if you're going to read and critique an expository essay, this is the first thing that you would look into. So, the first is the first category is a strong expository essay. You can say that an expository essay is a strong one if it got an introduction that dramatically sets the stage of the essay. If that expository essay got a great introduction, then we can say, or you can say, that it is a strong expository essay. Next, it should have a thesis statement that is clear and directly tackles the prompt. So what is this prompt that we are talking about for the past couple of minutes? So the writing prompt is the topic of an essay or any literary composition of yours. So for example, the writing prompt is about the negative effects of COVID-19 to senior high school students. So that could be a writing prompt. Now, in this second an example or this second point on how you can say an expository essay as a strong one, a thesis statement should be clear and directly tackles the prompt. Thus, the expository essay that you are reading and critiquing actually tackles the prompt, yes or no. If it is yes, on what level it is tackling it? Does it tackles the entirety of the prompt, or does it just tackles, or does it lack the power that you need on tackling such kind of writing prompt? So that is the way on how you can actually say that this expository essay or anything that any expository essay that you are reading and critiquing as a strong one. Next, does it have evidence that is suitable and suitably used? How we can say that the evidence used in an expository essay as suitable one? So once again, we as writers and authors are thinking ahead of time on our target readers, right? And also, we are constantly researching on the things that we can use and we can write about. Now, the question here is this: thus the things, or thus the ideas, the facts that you use as an evidence is suitable to the readers. Thus, the facts that you've gathered and used in your expository essay are actually reliable. Did you use it properly? Or did you just place those facts incoherently? Next, fourth one. Analysis is clearly based on using evidence to prove the thesis statement. So an analysis is really, really used, or an analysis should be really included in a strong expository essay. Okay, so there should be a clear representation of what is the stand of the essayist and to the subject matter itself, to the writing prompt itself. Okay, does he believe on the writing prompt as a good one, or does he believe that there is a lot of positive between the writing prompt, or there's this a negative effect on the COVID-19 thing, right? So there should be a clear analysis in there. Next is the logical reasoning that flows clearly from thesis to concluding statements. So what does this mean? So this only means that you want that expository essay to have this coherence into it. Right from the beginning till the end, you have this unity into what the expository essay is trying to explain to you. Okay, so if it have this strong thesis statement, then the ending of it or the conclusion of it should also have a strong impact to you, or strong statements in there. So all in all, there should always be a clear regularity between or in what you are doing, or in what the expository essay is trying to tell to you. Okay, so if the expository essay is very excellent at the beginning and in the middle, then at the ending or at the conclusion of it, it also be very excellent. Okay, next, the language evokes, shows, and tells. So on this one, this is all about how the language used on the expository essay actually helps you, the reader, and the critiquer to have the imagery of what is the writer is trying to tell you. Okay, so this is all about how he or she used or played with the words. So that is how you can say that an expository essay is a strong one. However, not all expository essays are strong. So there is another category called the average expository essay. So an average expository essay have an introduction that is confusing or is not staged dramatically. Next, It got a thesis statement that is not clearly established or not stated in direct response to the prompt. Third, it got an evidence that is insufficient or tries to prove too much. Okay, so what we need in evidence is just the right amount of it. Fourth, it got an analysis that does not link the evidence to the thesis statement. Yes, it might have an analysis, but it is improper. Next, it got a logical reasoning, but it does not flow coherently from thesis to conclusion. So there is a miscommunication there between or misrepresentation of what you want to answer of from the thesis statement down to the conclusion. Okay, and the last one, the language of it simply tells and follows correct grammar and syntax. However, it lacks the imagery. So that is what an average expository essay is. However, if we have an average, we have a strong, we have an average, we also have a weak expository essay. And the weak expository essay is simply filled with information. No good introduction, no dramatization of the introduction right there. It's just information, right from the start, information. Next, the thesis statement does not directly address the prompt. So, the thesis statement is not about the topic that the expository essay should be written all about. So, we can say that that expository essay is already weak one. Third, it got wrong evidences, or if ever that it have any good evidences or right evidences, it is used in a not right way or not right manner. It is used incorrectly. Fourth, the analysis does not support the thesis statement. Fifth, the conclusion is completely irrelevant, which means it does not make any sense or it does not make any connections to the other parts of the essay. And the last one is it has an inappropriate or incorrect use of language or grammar. If all of these 6 points were checked by you as a reader and critiquer, then that expository essay can be called as a weak one. Okay, so once again, we've got the strong, the average, and the weak expository essays. So free writing is the act of you just writing whatever it is that is going into your mind. Okay, and that is one of the best way for you to actually gather information. Okay, so while writing, we are actually using our brains, right? To think about what we want to write, to think about the things that interest us, to think about the things that might interest our readers. So whatever it is that it might come across to your mind, if you are actually free writing by that time, then you can actually write down those important things that you might use when the time comes that you're actually going to write your very own expository essay or your very own other literary composition. Now, actually, let's all remember that a good expository essay depends on the quality of information. That's why free writing is very important to us. Now, the quality of information is actually measurable by appropriateness and sufficiency to answer the prompt or the question that you want to answer. Hence, you need to identify or obtain quality information. You need to identify the questions about the topic. You need to identify the possible sources that would provide the answer to these questions. Okay, and by researching, you can actually see or find a lot of answers. You can find a lot of information about the writing prompt that you want to tackle about. You can find a lot of and various informations, particularly in the internet, about a certain topic. But you, as a writer, should have or find quality information. Okay? And the quality information can only be measured by its appropriateness and sufficiency. There's a lot of information, but you need to find the really good one, the quality information. Next, Now that we know how to free write, one of the best way for us to gather information aside from just plain browsing the internet or researching or reading a book, then we can actually now go to drafting an expository essay. So how are we supposed to draft our own essay? Let's first know what are the elements of an expository essay or the expository elements. So an expository essay got these following elements. The first one is that after gathering information, you as the writer should choose the expository technique for your topic or prompt. You need to gather additional information as needed. Okay? So you need to find as much or as many good and quality information as you can before even starting to write. Okay, so it is if that you're going to amass a lot of information that you as a writer would actually use in your future drafts or writing compositions. Next, the introduction of an expository expository essay should have the following element. It should have contained the thesis statement that clearly answers the prompt. Okay, it must be dramatically written to capture the reader's interest. And if you manage to do this one, then you will actually going to target the strong expository essay in terms of introduction and thesis statement. So that's already 2 points of you on being a strong expository essayist. Next, having that kind of powerful introduction, you must have a body. The body or the first paragraph of the body should support the thesis statement by discussing one of its claims or argument. So you, now that you have a thesis statement, the first paragraph should support it. Okay? May it be you are pro to that thesis statement or a con to that thesis statement. Next, the second paragraph in the body, of course, it should also support the thesis statement by discussing another of its claims or arguments. So the first paragraph is about its main claim or arguments, while the second paragraph is there to support the first paragraph. Okay? And the last paragraph or the third paragraph should support the thesis statement by providing additional evidences. So you want to provide here a lot of evidences that will actually make your readers believe on what you are trying to explain to them through your expository essay. So that is how you can actually create a strong expository essay, particularly a body of a strong expository essay. Now that we have an introduction and we have the body, the third element is the conclusion. So the conclusion should summarize the major arguments raised and reiterates the thesis statements and confirms the prompt. So whatever it is that is in your prompt, whatever argument that you've raised within your expository essay, whatever it is that is in your thesis statement, the conclusion should have it all in a way that it is trying to conclude. From the term itself, conclusion, you want to conclude everything. You want to summarize everything. You want to give an ending to the things that is happening. Okay? So that is how you can create a strong expository conclusion. Next, how are we going to develop a thesis statement? So we've been talking about thesis statement from the past couple of minutes now, but the question here right now is how can we create one? So a thesis statement first is the core of the expository essay, which means it encapsulates the idea that you want to expose, hence the term expository essay. You want to tell other people what it is that is in your mind or what is the topic that you are trying to tell them. Next, it contains actually 2 parts. So the thesis statement have these 2 main parts. The first one is the claim, and the second one is the evidence to support the claim. So for example, the thesis statement claims that the Dolomite sand or the dolomite thing in the Manila Bay is actually ecologically friendly. After that claim, the thesis statement should provide that claim with its own evidences. Okay, so that is how you can create your very own thesis statement. First, you should have a claim, and the second one or the second part of it, you should provide it with enough evidence that will actually make that claim strong. Developing a thesis is like constructing a bridge. The thesis is the roadway of the bridge, and the columns under the bridge make the bridge function properly. These columns are the evidence that support the thesis itself. Now, in developing a thesis statement, you need to combine the claim and the supporting evidence in a single sentence. So, for example, drug addiction is a complex issue that requires examination of its causes, symptoms, and effective treatment. Now, simply stating that drug addiction is a complex issue is a weak thesis statement because it does not indicate the columns or supporting evidence that would make it stand up like a bridge. Such a statement is only a claim, a bridge roadway with no supporting columns. So on this example of a thesis statement, we can actually see the claim itself, which is drug addiction is a complex issue. And the evidence, because it requires examination of its causes, symptoms, and effective treatment. Because of this evidences wherein we need to examine the cause, symptoms, and effective treatment, you are actually supporting your main claim, which is drug addiction is a complex issue. And comparing it to this one, which is drug addiction is a complex issue, which is just a claim without any supporting details or any evidences, you can actually analyze it or say, or for example, in an analogy, we only have here the roadway of the bridge and we do not have the columns that will actually support the bridge itself, which in turn will make the bridge collapse. Now, so that is how you are going to create your thesis statement. You need to have the claim and afterwards you need to have the evidences. And that is all for this topic. So we now learned how to develop our very own thesis statement. We've learned how to read and critique a writing prompt. We've learned what a strong expository essay is, an average and a weak one. And we've learned how to explain certain things under our expository techniques. So all in all, if you're going to use all of those ideas, all of those knowledge that I've just given to you in the last couple of minutes that I've been talking here, you can actually write your own strong expository essay or read and critique others' expository essay and actually say whether it is strong, average, or weak. Now, since it's the second to the last part of our lessons for this subject matter, for this whole course that you are taking from me, which is creative nonfiction, I just want to tell you guys that you should never give up on writing. Never give up on writing and pursue excellence. And now for your activity, for your performance task number 5, you need to open and complete the document entitled Q2 Lesson 4 R9 _ Creative Nonfiction _ Sir Michael _ Worksheet number 6. Now, let me open up to you guys. So this is your performance task number 5, which is the worksheet number 6. As always, you need to write here your personal information, which is your name and section. Also, your strand. You need to read this direction and understand it. The direction is as follow. Make your own writing prompt and construct a 300-word expository essay. So here, you're going to write your writing prompt. And this is the line that I've given for you to write your very own expository essay. So yeah, that's it. 300 words once again. So this is the rubrics that I'm going to use to create that expository essay of yours. This is the rubric that I've been using for the couple of days, weeks, and months that we've been discussing. So I will not read it to you guys because I already know that you are already very familiar to it since we've used it multiple of times. Okay, so an example of writing prompt are as follows. For example, you can have this prompt number one, which is say something, or some say that speaking in English makes the Filipino less nationalistic. Explain why this is not so. So this is an example of writing prompt. If you want to use it, then you may do so. Or if you want to create your own prompt, then you may also do that. Another example of a writing prompt is this one. Strict enforcement of rule is often cited as one of the solutions for progress in the country. Explain why this is so. And the third example of writing prompt is this one. Press freedom contributes to people's active involvement in the country's affairs. Explain why this is so. So these three examples of writing prompts are very good writing prompts that you can actually use if you want to do so, unless you want to create your very own writing prompt. Okay, so that is your performance task number 5, which is worksheet number 6. Let's now go back to your presentation. So that's the performance task, guys. And once again, these are the references that I've used. Remember, never give up on writing and pursue excellence. And yeah, credits the Slides Carnival and Unsplash once again for this great powerful PowerPoint presentation template. And yeah, thank you guys for watching till the end, and I'll see you on our last meeting the following of days. Cut.